Hi everybody, I'm Dan Mustard from Milray Center. This is a drum circle. There is a zoom lens on that camera. We're actually practicing social distancing right now. We're really 6 feet apart, but the camera lens makes it look like we're much closer than that. All right, we're gonna do some drumming here because drumming is really, really good for a lot of different things. It's a great stress reliever. It's also really good for your brain. It's something that we do here at Milray Center every Monday at 1 o'clock. So when we are not on a lockdown and a quarantine, we will be doing drum circle again. So in the meantime, what we want to do is give everybody an opportunity to kind of join us and do a little bit of drumming right now. So I'm just going to give you some real basic tips about drumming. We're going to start by just stretching out. So just put your arms straight out, grab your fingertips and pull back. And we're going to warm that up a little bit. Very good, down. Turn your hand over and pull down on the top of your hand this way. Okay, now the other hand. Just getting things warmed up and stretched out a little bit. Okay, fingers down. Good, now shake your hands up a little bit. All right, when we play the drum, a couple things to keep in mind. We're gonna use this part of our hand, right below the bottom of the fingers, the part where we have calluses, because that's the part of our hand that's the toughest. We're gonna use that by hitting right here on the edge of the drum, and our fingers together, and our fingers can actually hit the drum head when that part hits first, so it sounds like this. Okay, the other sound that we can get from the drum is by keeping our hand together kind of cupped. We're gonna hit right in the middle of the drum like this. Four, three, two, one, stop. And do the same thing, okay? Now the way that we can create patterns without having to really know a lot about music is to use some really simple phrases in English. So if I say Pop-Tarts, chicken nuggets, it's a nonsense phrase, but it's actually a great way to create a rhythm. So if we just play the rhythm of Pop-Tarts, chicken nuggets, it would sound like this. Pop-Tarts, chicken nuggets, Pop-Tarts. Another thing that we can do is to do something that we call it follow the leader. It's an echo where I will play and then you can play back to me. And if you don't have a drum at home, feel free to grab anything that'll make noise. You can grab a trash can, turn it upside down. These drums are actually 5 gallon buckets and they have little drum lids that are called Remo rhythm lids, and you can just snap those on top of it. 5 gallon bucket and you can play that, right? But a drum, a waste can, a trash can, anything, plastic bowl, you can use all kinds of things to make a drum. As long as it's comfortable, it will make a sound. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little bit of call and response now, a little bit of echo. I'm gonna play something and I want you to play it back. Here we go, ready? One, two, three, four. Thank you. Kaylee have never done a drum circle before, so they're able to do this. So, yeah. So, you don't have to be an experienced musician to be able to play along. It's really, really good for stress, and it's good for your brain. Some research has indicated, actually, that playing drums with a group of people is actually just as effective for mental health issues as antidepressants, right? So this is a great opportunity for people who can't get out right now to see a health professional. You can still do some things to reduce stress. Drumming is one of them. All right, let's do another pattern. This time we're going to play something just a little bit more complicated. We're going to play peas and ham, peanut butter sandwich. Right, peas and ham, peanut butter sandwich. Let's play that together. One, two, three, four. Peas and ham, peanut butter sandwich. Good job. Now we're going to divide that up, and Daniel and Kaylee are going to play peas and ham. Linda and Evan are going to play peanut butter sandwich. Peas and ham, peanut butter sandwich, and I'll play along with the whole thing. Here we go. Ready? One, two, three, four. Peas and ham. Okay, we're going to finish up with one last little phrase. This is called coffee, coffee, add a little sugar. Okay, coffee, coffee, add a little sugar. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Coffee. Thank you. job, everybody. Okay, we're going to be back with some more of these. So remember, all you have to do is just grab something and start beating on it. Hopefully it's an inanimate object.
Our youngest son is the cameraman, and he's dancing the whole time. So if you know Sean, you understand why we're laughing.
Okay. So we'll be back. We'll be doing some more of these throughout the next few days, so be watching. And then when all the craziness is done, we'll be back here at Milray Center, 1 o'clock on Mondays. Feel free to join us. Thanks.
Goodbye,
everybody. Wash your hands.